Can you tell us a little bit more about how you treat metastatic disease in Japan and how you sequence the treatments? Mm-hmm.
So for HER2 negative case, average with fluoropyrimidine and platinum agent as a first line, followed by paclitaxel and ramucirumab is commonly used, and it was most recommended treatment sequence in our guideline. Maybe I think this is not so different from other countries. Our guideline is more simple to recommend most recommended one. But NCCN guidelines have more various treatment options. But we are currently revising this guideline, and we will increase the variation of treatment as an optional treatment. But I think most recommended treatments seem to be almost the same.
Yeah, and in the first line, you also have access to S1, where we don't.
Yeah. We commonly use S1 rather than capecitabine, but both can be used, and also we can use FOLFOX. And regarding the HER2 targeting agent, we usually use trastuzumab in combination with either combination with fluoropyrimidine and platinum. And as a second line, paclitaxel and ramucirumab is surely recommended, most recommended type of treatment based on Rainbow study. We also joined the Rainbow study and enrolled 140 patients. It showed a clear survival benefit, so we used this regimen if patient had no contraindication. Even for the HER2 positive case, we used paclitaxel and ramucirumab. And going back to the previous question about the early disease progression after triple regimen, we are not so commonly used triple regimen, but there are several clinical trials is ongoing to evaluate triple regimen. And from this experience, we use lower dose of docetaxel, so paclitaxel-based regimen seem to be active even after the docetaxel-based regimen. So paclitaxel and ramucirumab is commonly used after DCS or a DOS regimen, triplet regimen. And as a third line, we use irinotecan. Clearly, this kind of continuation of treatment might be very important to prolong the survival.
Yeah, and it sounds like everybody's thinking about sort of doublet, single plus targeted agent, single, to try to continue that sort of thought of prolonging survival but not giving so much chemo.
And I always tell my patients, you have to think about it as a long-term plan, but also use standard and experimental therapies as stepping stones. Mm-hmm. So you're trying to cross a river. The more stepping stones you have, the better.
That's a great way to look at it. Okay, Manish, I'm going to hit you on two things. First is, when we're talking about the stepping stones, do we actually set the size of the stepping stone? Whoa, so what am I talking about? Nobody ever knows. Okay, so the question is, for the first line treatment, there are several different approaches you can take, right? Because we treat people with colon cancer with FOLFOX, and then we do this sort of maintenance type regimen. But also in gastric cancer, and we've seen this in several trials, you use chemo for 6 months and you're out and you're done. So what's your thought on where we should go with this?
Great. I had to take notes for a second. So I think outside of the UK, I think many people would actually not stop chemo entirely. I think that we would do a doublet for most patients and then drop the more toxic agent, the platinum, and continue 5-FU of some variety, kind of in a maintenance or less intensive therapy. I think with our increasing number of treatments, this is going to be important because people may actually need to have chemotherapy holidays or breaks. And that's where single agent ramucirumab actually may be really wonderful because, as Ian mentioned, single agent activity is equal to single agent activity with the cytotoxic.
Yes, yeah.
But you know, I think the other part of it is that in the next 6 months to a year, we very likely might have a PD-1 inhibitor approved for gastric cancer. And then if we start with the doublet, and then we use Taxol Ram, and then we use irinotecan, and then we use the PD-1 inhibitor, people won't get there. Mm-hmm. And that's another reason to think about our first line, our strategy, in an important way. The idea of combining a target agent with a three-drug regimen, I think that's been proven actually in large trials for epirubicin-based therapy, as you know, with an EGFR antibody inhibitor and epirubicin-based therapy, but not true for like a modified DCF or FLOT regimen. We published a modified DCF with Avastin and actually had a very good outcome and also equal safety safety aspect. So I think I wouldn't clump all three drug regimens together.